Unfortunately, her coach Sampat Kumar was not in this world to see his prediction come true. Dorai Raz was born in a small village in the Indian state of Tamil Nadu. After his schooling, he joined the Indian Air Force as a technician. After a few years, he got married and became the father of two lovely children. His family was just like any other Indian middle-class family. The only difference was that the children had freedom to dream out of the box, and parents supported them wholeheartedly. As a result, in a country where cricket has the status of a religion, his daughter became the highest run scorer in the history of women cricket. Friends, this is the story of Mithali Raj and her family's hard work and dedication. This is the story of Mithali's struggle, in which she not only made a name for herself but also helped the Indian women's cricket team to rise from a level where players were not even provided t-shirts with their own names to a position where two Bollywood biopics are being made on them. Mithali was born in Jodhpur, Rajasthan, where her father was on his last Air Force posting. After retiring from the Air Force, her father joined Andhra Bank and settled in Hyderabad. Despite limited resources, her family was open-minded about raising children and gave equal importance to both sports and studies. When Mithali was just 6 years old, her elder brother Mithun used to go to a sports academy every morning to learn cricket. Mithali did not like to wake up in the morning, but due to her interest in sports, she used to go to the ground with Mithun every day. There, Mithun's coach, in his spare time, used to play with Mithali for fun. Gradually, he noticed the cricketing talent in Mithali, and one day he told Mithali's mother that they should pay attention to Mithali's game as well. He suggested Mithali's parents to meet Sampat Kumar, the coach at National Institute of Sports. Mithali trained for about 2 months in Sampat Kumar's Girls Cricket Sports Club. Sampat Kumar was so impressed with Mithali's game that he called her parents and told them the girl is very good and can play for the country in future. At first, Mithali's family did not take the matter very seriously, but Sampat Kumar was very confident about Mithali's game and told her parents, Mithali has the talent to play for the country and I am ready to take up this challenge as a coach. But as parents, are you ready for this? You have to be completely dedicated. Then only we can work on it. I want her to play for the country very soon. If Sachin Tendulkar can do it at the age of 14, then why can't Mithali do the same? That South Indian middle class family, where natural choices for children's career were limited to becoming a doctor or an engineer, agreed to let their only daughter pursue sports as a career. Mithali's training started, and at the age of 9, she became the youngest player to be selected in the sub-junior team of the state. Even at such a young age, she had to travel all over the country for sports. Sometimes, she had to stay away from home for 15 to 20 days in a month. After the sub-junior team, Mithali was selected in the junior and senior team as well. At every stage, her mother stood behind her firmly. She had to even leave her job to take care of Mithali. To save time by avoiding public transportation for practice, she would drop and pick up Mithali on her scooter every day. When Mithali was 14 years old, she came very close to fulfilling her coach's dream, as she was selected among the probables of the 1997 Cricket World Cup team. But she could not make it to the final team. She was a little disappointed, but without giving up, continued to play domestic cricket with full focus. And finally, at the age of 17, she was selected for the national team. Despite cricket being very popular in India, the condition of women's cricket was not good in those days. They had to struggle for basic things like proper uniform, travel, and boarding facilities. In spite of that, she scored 114 not out against Ireland in her very first match. Unfortunately, her coach Sampat Kumar was not in this world to see his prediction come true. He died in an accident 2 years ago. After her selection in the national team, Mithali never looked back and went on to become the highest run scorer in international cricket. She is the only female player to score 7 consecutive half centuries. She also became the first Indian cricketer to score 2000 runs in T20 internationals. After being awarded the Padma Shri, the Arjun Award and the highest sports honor, the Khel Ratna, she retired from international cricket on 8th June 2022. Her story depicts the incredible passion and dedication of a 6-year-old girl and her family. They knew very well that apart from talent, hard work and dedication, the biggest and most important input for achieving great success is time. She continued to work on her goal without losing sight of her focus, and by the age of 39, conquered the whole world. Friends, we must always remember that if we continue to look for water by digging a new pit every day, we may not succeed. But if we keep digging the same pit a little deeper every day, we will eventually find water within it. Thank you.